always right inside. One love, one race, that's right. Home before any place, truth before anything, power, love, slay the hate. I said home before any place, truth before anything, power, love, slay the hate. Well, starve it, find that light that is old from days gone by. But in darkness, walk my neighbors with the sickness of the mind. Watching from the corner, through the shadows, the surface evil eyes. With all scarlet. I gotta get some shit off my chest. And fit to see me at the core since like 8 days or less. And it's a sickness of the mind that destroys and divides the wages of the cynical death. A body, soul, and mind. A fat pig on the coast flat. The roots of instant and it's incessantly insistent. It embodies ignorance along with its asinine benefits. Basically, it's just following the demon's leadership while we try for atmospheres of hate and intolerance. Hate supposed which is burning in the time of the Puritans. Yes, the human condition is greatly flawed, but I must believe its potential is far beyond the words of the song. We're all scarlet, by that light that is gold from days gone by. When in darkness, walk my neighbors with the sickness of the mind. And watching from the corner, through the shadows, except for evil eyes. We're all scarlet. Red rivers flow through mountains of corpses from the falls of time. And all our voices are unfolded from the snapshot. Humanity's history has a stain of blood on it so large. At times, it's all you see. That scarlet red imperfection is what forever. History books in schools to point out the red stains in all the faces of the soldiers in battles. For the black, white, brown, and Chinese, such a thing as slavery was allowed here. This land of the white cross, a burning cross, it seemed to continue to haunt society. Hateful signs to divide from diamonds to bus seats. At the stuff of what's being discussed, it's no problem. Blood kept flowing, still no one noticed. A nation of old beast minds. Thoughts fat and lazy, so we spin our wheels in the same old degradation. Running over the same old ground, finding the same old fears. There are so many real demons and reasons lurking out here in the world. But how can we begin to face them? If we take it past ourselves first, unity is made. So we're left alone in dark corners as we pray for Lucifer's beast to take. Yes, the human condition is greatly flawed, but I must believe this potential is far beyond. Listen to my anthem, to my song. We're all scarlet, by that light that is rolled from days gone by. In darkness, walk my neighbors with the sickness of the mind. And watching from the corner, through the shadows, the surface evil eyes. We're all scarlet, by that light that is rolled from days gone by. In darkness, walk my neighbors with the sickness of the mind. And watching from the corner, through the shadows, we're all scarlet and scarlet by the light that has grown from days gone by. But in darkness, walk my neighbors with their sickness of the mind. And watching from the corner through the shadows, Lucifer's evil eyes. Home before any place, truth before anything, power, love, slay the hate. When you say it matters what lies within, and then you judge a man by the color of his skin, the irony of your hypocrisy is, inside you're the same color as him. Personally, I tend to get lightheaded and faint when the doctor takes my blood. A gene thing, but how for our entire race, it's a source of strength. If you've ever tasted your own blood, you've tasted a piece of every man forever and forever through history. I was watching the History Channel about the history of the KKK. I vividly remember my veins flow with disgust and rage, and giving them support and cover-ups was our own government. Going about preaching love and values that were Christian, and what they spread was hate and fear, and what they brought was death. Is it a surprise their leader was found drunk with the rape corpse of a woman on that train when they preached against alcohol and the white woman's purity? Is it not fundamentally, obviously evident? Racism is the handiwork of the devil here. Besides a murder, what's more innately evil? I know someone who talked about how the black kids in her school in Alabama were bullies and just gave mean stares at her. What, are you kidding me? Are you an adult? Can you not think and look around and have some maturity? Please, it was the Deep South in the 60s, and kids do these things. I guess you believe everyone everywhere are the same, regardless of anything. Since the white man came to this land and uprooted the Indian from his home and brought over slaves, he treated every race like dirt. And let's not start how the Latin man can be treated today. Same person said the fact there's a BET, Black Entertainment TV, is racist. Seriously? Are there not numerous Latino channels and ones based on one's nationality? What, you think because of that there should be a fucking white power one? That celebration of your heritage doesn't mean you discriminate the rest of it. Besides, we here share a national unifying heritage of America. How can you complain if the family line didn't come from a minority in oppression and slavery? It's not about what anyone owes today, but remembering the evil from which we came. So history progresses forward because it does have a tendency to repeat. I lived in Central America for years, and I got a life-changing experience. And many life-changing perspectives, yeah. But I also found the same old things. People saying America is racist. Crap like all blacks are dangerous. Just a shame, look, to generalize about any one group of people and you're heading down a dark and dangerous path. Each person is an individual. Your race doesn't define you. It's one of many aspects that make up who you are, among other things such as economic status, nationality, sex, religion, and a person is who they are based on their own personal decisions and experiences. Just because you share the same color doesn't mean you automatically relate to someone. A white junkie in Detroit has more in common with a white lawyer in Boston than two childhood friends, one white, one black, that grew up together in the same rich community with the same aspirations in California. As for America as a whole, our history is ironically like the Romans and all great powers through history, bloodstained. But look at us today. When I came back to the States with my wife from Central America, I said, look around. From the park to the mall, there were all types of people of all different colors together, friends to lovers, in every type of relationship. And look at our movies and music and stars and sports teams. Young white kids grow up with black heroes and vice versa. There's diversity in every profession, truck driver to doctor. Kids today truly grow up in an atmosphere that's colorblind. Not that they don't see the differences, but they're given no big deal here. Our nation elected our first black president. It evokes a lot of pride at the progress and the promise of us as a nation and a species. At the very essence of the progress of humanity, we are scarlet. And every truth through eternity.